Local synagogue is taking no chances and being precautious. It's holding a safety drill just days after a man from the Upper Peninsula is arrested and planning a mass shooting that didn't happen at an East Lansing synagogue.
Yeah, Priya Mann live in Southfield this morning, and this training session was already scheduled, Priya, now, but it takes on even more urgency because of what we were just talking about.
Yeah, that's right. When you consider the rise in anti-Semitism here in Michigan and across the country, synagogues like this one in Southfield, they want to take every precaution they can. They're actually bringing in specialists from Jerusalem for this EMS training here today. And this is in response to what organizers here say is just a troubling increase in anti-Semitic acts.
The focus this afternoon at the Shari Zedek Synagogue is on how to save lives in the aftermath of a mass shooting. This comes after the FBI arrested a 19-year-old from the UP. The Michigan teen is accused of plotting a terror attack at a synagogue in East Lansing. The feds say Sean Paitilla bought multiple weapons and ammunition, and in his notes, police found the location of the East Lansing Synagogue, where investigators say the attack would take place.
All Jews everywhere know that the risk of an anti-Semitic attack exists, but to hear there was actually one being plotted against them is terrifying.
This latest arrest comes amid a troubling rise in anti-Semitism across the country. According to the Anti-Defamation League, there was a 36% increase in anti-Semitic incidents in 2022 compared to 2021. It's the highest number on record since the organization began tracking incidents in 1979. Most incidents occurred in synagogues, Jewish community centers, and schools. The organization say most involved harassment and threats against Jewish people.
We're doing trainings nonstop. We do them every month. We actually were just at the one at Shari Zedek in East Lansing about a month and a half ago. We did one on Zoom and did a training for them. And so they knew sort of what to do. It's, people, we need them to be prepared. Not alarmed, but prepared.
And the emergency response training is set for 1 o'clock today. Again, they are bringing in paramedics and specialists for Jerusalem to aid in that training. The message here is we will not live in fear, but we will be prepared. Reporting live in Southfield, I'm Priya Mann, Local 4.